We got two speakers, kindly.
Sir, thank you, sir.
Honorable members के लिए जो है वो special refreshment की व्यवस्था parliamentary affair ministry ने की है और staff के लिए भी room number 73 में खाने की व्यवस्था की गई है इसलिए जब तक चलाइए हमने अब जो हमारी duty थी हमने कर दिया जो आपकी duty है वो करिए
see excuse me whoever is to speak I'm here
thank you sir
kindly please cooperate
thank you sir sir this is I am a retiring member this is the last time I am getting a chance to speak here sir even though I am starting with a protest sir because the
please sit down
I am starting with a protest because there was a earlier notice last session onwards a statutory motion was lying today was it was listed yesterday and today to reverse the excise duty but the government what is doing in other cases like that they are cutting all the agendas and taking out the right of the members individual members in this house sir regarding this BAC decided and it was in the list I don't know if the government is not interested to have that kind of discussion so sir the excise duty which is connected to this budget also because of the excise duty additional charges they are getting for 3 or 4 lakhs whatever the income they are additionally getting it is not included so it is connected to the budget sir now because of the food arranged the time is relaxed I think so others also will get time so sir I am not taking much of the time sir this budget is a quantitative expression of a plan for a definite period of time that is what one definition about budget sir the budget which the government is placed here is not having any perspective plan for the future sir the country is facing some serious economic crisis as the global economic crisis is affecting our country also so the contraction the purchasing power is coming down the employment opportunities are coming down so the government have to spend more in public sector but actually in this budget no such attitude or not such focus is there so sir our domestic production is decreasing our export is decreasing every aspect of our economy it is having the negative aspect and our tax revenue is also decreasing if we go into the details sir public investment is the only way to overcome these kind of issues but the government's attitude to restrict the fiscal deficit the 3.5% as government is successful in controlling that by that what they are doing they are not spending money for they are not spending the spending money and that is why the employment in different areas is not coming up sir there is an argument that the crowding out argument because private for helping the private sector government should not borrow much and this government is following that government is not borrowing much government is not doing the deficit financing that is why that two argument but even from the Roosevelt period the new deal the mixed economy that time onwards the public spending is very important for helping the corporate they are saying that PPP model is good but PPP model is a failure in the country that is why the recent example of writing of 1.14 lakhs of crores from the Indian banks as NPA is because of the PPP model which they are following sir government have to spend more for the public sector and it will only help sir the economic survey says about the need of more public spending more investment but practically that is not happening for that additional mobilization of resources is needed but it is only 20,000 crores that we additionally mobilize sir tax gdp rate in the country is the lowest in the world one of the lowest in the world for tax gdp for increasing the tax gdp rate that percentage the government is not doing anything and if you go to the details of the detailed plan see sir in the plan itself it shows that the government is surviving because of or the financial crisis we are overcoming because of the higher income from the excise duty sir union excise duty if you calculate 1 rupee out of the 1 rupee which is coming to the government how much is the last year's excise duty it was 10% of the total income but now it is 12% because 2% extra is coming from the from the excise duty, that is through petroleum. Sir, non-tax revenue is also, if we look into the difference, non-tax revenue is also like that. From 10%, it is coming to 13%. Sir, if you look to corporate tax, yearly rate was 20%. Corporate tax was 20%. Now, this year, it is only 19%. That means it is coming down. In effect. So, this is the attitude of the government, and this shows... No, sir. This shows the attitude of the government.
No, means...
Sir, because of the resource mobilization, because the petroleum they are getting. Actually, the tax thing, how much is the tax foregone? In this budget, this year budget, it is not shown. Generally, it is giving. But yesterday, I got a reply in this house. It says that 5,54,349 is the tax foregone. It is given by the Honorable Minister. Minister is sitting here. So, in the income tax level, in the this financial year, 1,18,593 is the tax foregone. And if you go to indirect taxes, it is 4,36,756.
The other speaker is speaking or not from your part?
Other speaker is speaking, sir.
Then, please.
Other speaker is speaking, sir.
Please.
Last speech, other speaker is speaking, and if you are not...
Retiring speech.
Retiring speech. Sir, this is a retiring speech, not maiden, but this is opposite to maiden, sir.
So, I can understand. I can show you some concern, but kindly.
Okay, sir. No. I am not... generally, you know, sir, I am
always
an obedient member of this house,
I know,
sir.
I know.
Sir, regarding the petroleum, I want to say about the great... I cannot say it's a cheating. But the people are exploited because of the petroleum pricing policy of this government. Sir, this is a Indian petroleum and natural gas statistics published by the government. If you go to the details, sir, the petroleum price there, government is saying that. I asked about the total import. The total import value last year of petroleum was 6,87,350, while the petroleum price per barrel was $84. Now it is $32, sir, or around 30. So the difference between the last year import to this year import, as per the data of the Petroleum Ministry, 4,12,410 lakh crores. That is lakh crores is the difference. As per your all account, it is showing only 2 lakh crore, but the Petroleum Ministry's publication is showing that it is 4,12,410 crore, the decrease in the total cost of the Indian petroleum import. So that is, this is very important, sir. This money, the difference you are not giving to the people, and at the same time you are helping only big corporates. You are giving away the taxes, and that way you are not helping. And sir, Kingfisher like companies, not only Kingfisher, I am warning the government now, many new companies like Paytm, Flickr, Amazon, all these companies are ballooning their accounts and taking big loan, huge loans from the banks. Again, you have to give this NPA. This is not a left or right or center that politics. I am saying about the Indian exchequer. Now these companies are ballooning. Now some arguments are coming. These big companies are taking money, and it is natural loss. No, sir, it is not a natural loss. So through the petroleum price balancing, you cannot save the country.
Balagopal, you have to tax. Mr. Balagopal, please.
And just I am coming, sir. The farmers in this country, as a policy, the farmers of the country
already
is not protected. Farmers of the country is not protected. Rubber is there, you know, sir. Other items are there. ASEAN agreement is there, sir. There is no provision to protect the farmers of the country now as a policy. Earlier, when I came 6 years back, sir, the people who were sitting there, now they are sitting here, people are less here. Why they came here? Because of these policies. We fought together. Now also we are fighting. Sir, I think if the government wants to continue there like this, they have to change the policy. Not only rubber farmers, other all traditional industry. Now cashew, last tax, Mr. Honorable Minister, the import of cashew, there is a new tax now. The entire industry, cashew industry in Kerala is closed.
Thank you, Mr. Balagopal.
3 lakh, sir, I am closing down, sir. I am concluding, sir. 3 lakh. Traditional industrial workers working in cashew industry, they lost their employment. Sir,
thank you sir, very much.
Just one more thing, sir.
No,
finally,
please.
Because our telecom ministry is there. Sir, telecom ministry is there.
Your party has got 6 minutes, but two speakers.
Making India, making India, we are saying, sir, we are making good, we are very good in software.
6 minutes, please.
But we are, sir, only one point. If you allow, I'll conclude. Otherwise, I'll speak like,
please.
Sir, the making India, we are very good in software development. Hardware, we are nowhere there. Sir, if we are, we can, even Chandrayaan and Mangalyaan we have. So if you have a plan to develop our hardware industry, our other core industries, we have to do something. So Make in India and other policies, we support that kind of idea. But these kind of areas, including our BSNL, MTNL, ministries doing
Mr.
something.
Bhupendra Singh.
So these industries we have to do. And about NRIs. NRI, now department is closed. Pawasi department is not there.
Speak.
So NRIs also we have to do something because they are giving more money than FII.
I can hear.
The foreign institutional investors.
No,
so we have to do something to...
I have been very, very lenient to you, considering your position.
Thank you,
but
sir.
But I have to answer the Deputy Chairman. Please, Bhupendra Singh. Yeah.
We will always remember you. We wish you very well. Keep it up.
Good compliments on behalf of the House. Thank you, Minister.